would be deferred by the buyers.
All right, Prashant, hang in there. We have a lot of guests joining us as well. We have Mr. Mani also. But before we get to all of them, we go across to Timsi, who was closest to where the action was. Timsi, what exactly are you picking up now? Companies have the option to perhaps, you know, go back to the old rates for the interim period. This is for the under construction properties.
Well, to be precise, this is what states wanted, that it should be an option for the states, for the developers where the project is already under construction, because under construction projects have for a lot of their procurement, they've already paid taxes, ITC credit is due to them. And government also feels in their impact analysis that once they shift to the new rates, ITC benefit will not be available, which they will not be able to pass on or themselves claim it, which would actually push up the cost of the project, where a flat or any under construction property, residential property, is below the price of 2 crore rupees. That means for the small segment, for the affordable segment, for the mid segment, the costs were going up as per the new rates. And thus, the council unanimously decided that it should be an option for an interim period left with the developers, that whether they want to continue with the old rates with ITC or new rates without ITC. But for the new projects, beginning 1st of April, the new rates will be mandatory. That is 1% for affordable housing and 5% for other than affordable housing. Also, some of the concerns that states had expressed on behalf of their state calculations, on behalf of their developers, on behalf of their home buyers, which was that up to 15% of commercial space in a residential property, how will that be treated? And council has decided that up to 15% of commercial space will be treated as a residential property only. Say, for example, in a township where the 15% is a commercial space, which is actually a necessity for that particular township to grow. So for those cases, they want that no mismanagement of taxes or no mismanagement of tax invoices or GST is done. So they have given a limit of 15% of any residential project which is commercial to be treated as residential only. That is again coming up at the rates of 1% and 5% in the new structure, and remaining under construction would be again to the back to the as an option available for the developers, whether to keep the old rates or new rates.
Timsi, thanks a lot
so
for
this,
that.
This proposal gives a breather to both home buyers, developers, and states.
All right, supposedly a breather to both home buyers, developers, and the state. Thanks a lot for all those details, Timsi. Let's go across to JC Sharma, who is the Vice Chairman and MD of Sobha, on the phone line with us. Mr. Sharma, is this what the industry wanted? Is this what the industry got?
Absolutely right. This is what the industry has asked for, and this is what the government and the GST Council has considered, because on the under-construction projects, allowing us to go with the input tax credit is going to ensure that we continue with the pricing which has been acceptable to the customer and which we continue with the momentum what we have got. As far as the new projects are concerned, we are in alignment with the GST Council's decision that we will be charging 5% or 1%, whatever is applicable on the new projects. Because there we do not wish to consider that input tax. Now, from a pricing point of view, we will be taking that as a part of construction cost, and the pricing will be determined on that basis.
Mr. Sharma, if you could give us some details, you know, how much of under construction projects are there right now in the industry? Number one. Number two, how much of unutilized tax credit is there in? And number three, if at all you go ahead and choose the newer option, will there be an impact on the margins?
Of course, yes. That is why we have been requesting and we have been asking the GST Council not to go for the optics, look at the ground reality, look at the margins, look at the acceptability of these prices, and on the under construction projects, which conservatively, I believe, in any city, it will be equivalent to 1.5 to 2 years of their annual consumption. to that an extent, if they have sold 50% or 40% of those under construction inventory, and on that suddenly they find that the customers who were sold with, say, 12% of GST now being asked that they will only pay 5% and our input cost goes up, would have been a double whammy. And we believe that via this process, we should be able to sustain, maintain our margins. We should be able to work with our development partners as well, because unnecessarily their stake would have gone up from a revenue sharing point of view. That gets avoided. And in the new projects, definitely that 5% and 1% will work perfectly fine with us.
Mr. Sharma, just from a Sobha developer's perspective, a couple of things again. How much is the unutilized input tax in your books? What is your under construction book looking like right now? And which segment do you think will get impacted more? Will it be affordable, luxury, or the mid segment?
None of the segments will get impacted. Once the clarity has come, I think the buyers who have been there on the sidelines, they will start taking the call. As far as our company is concerned, in two of our major markets, Bangalore as well as in Gurgaon, we do not have any input tax credit available per se. So we are not going to, would not have got affected. In some other places, small input tax credit would have been there, but that was not the real cause of concern. As I repeat, the real cause of concern for most of the developers who have been selling at around 6,500 or so per square feet was the sudden change in the structure where input tax would have become the cost. And we believe that the request what we have put up, they understood that this is what the reality is and perfectly in alignment with our thought process.
All right, there is some deliberation on the fact that 15% of commercial property will be treated as residential. Do you think this does make sense? And if at all, then what could the impact be?
See, there are not many projects, to the best of my understanding, mm-hmm. where 15% kind of commercial projects in residential projects will be there, seven except Pune or in Maharashtra, but big picture I'm talking about. Mm. So to that extent, how it will pan out, I am not in a position to comment right now.
All right. Thanks a lot, Mr. Sharma, for joining in. Meanwhile, we have MS Money, the partner at Deloitte India, joining us on the phone line. Mr. Money, thanks a lot for joining in. First up, could you tell us how much is the unutilized input tax in the industry right now? And if at all this was to reverse, how would it impact the balance sheets of all the companies?
I think it would be very difficult for anybody to put mm-hmm. a number on, the quantum of input tax credits. But the key point over here, to my mind, are twofold. Mm. For a very long time, the real estate sector was harping on the fact that the rates were very high, and that was suppressing demand. And the rates were therefore brought down. And then the issue arose as to what we do in respect of input tax credits, which are already accumulated. So to my mind, the fact that government has given two options to the real estate sector, stating that, look, in respect of under construction, bear in mind, we'll have to wait and see whether they come out with some rule as to what constitutes under construction. So if a building construction has just started and it's just 10% completed, would that also be under construction? We'll have to wait for the rules to come. But for under construction projects, if they are permitted to avail input tax credit for any point of time in future, so this could be even 6 months from now, where they keep selling apartments which are under construction, because real estate is long gestation. Now, that, to my mind, will really, really assist all the builders and all the developers. Because this is a requirement which has come in all of the sudden last month. Real estate being long gestation, many builders did not know what exactly they should do because they had a lot of stock of raw material. Many of them had planned for purchases. What do you do in respect of input tax credit? One key point that we have to bear in mind is as far as the real estate sector, which makes it different from all other sectors, is the fact that this is a sector which has got some inputs which are taxed, cement at 28%, most of the other inputs at 18%. And therefore, their ability to absorb the input tax cost would be very, very limited when they are denied input tax credit. So keeping this in mind, when you look at the fact that they have been given two options now, that you either use the input tax credit route in respect of under construction projects for whatever, maybe 6 months, maybe 1 year till you are able to sell it off. And in respect of new projects, it becomes mandatory because new project pricing would not yet been decided. And therefore, if there is a marginal loss of input tax credit, that can be factored into the price of new projects.
All right.
To my mind, what government has done today is very, very pragmatic, although we'll have to wait for the rules to come out.
All right, Mr. Mani, thanks a lot for joining in. Before we wrap this discussion up, let's get in a final word coming in from Prashant. Prashant, what do you make of these developments? Everyone is hailing it. More importantly, is there enough demand in the system for all these things to, you know, go through smoothly?
See, a couple of things we need to keep in mind. Now, as of now, in the industry, there are close to 15 lakhs of units which are in under construction stage. And out of it, there are 35% of the project which are nearing completion, which would, you know, in another, let's say, 1 year to 6 months, these projects would be completed. So this is one point that we need to keep in mind before we conclude something. Now, the second aspect of this verdict today that, you know, the new projects that are being launched April onward, 1st April onward, will have to follow the new rulings. So in my opinion, the pricing of these new projects, which will be launched after 1st of April, would slightly factor in the loss of input tax credit. So what I mean to say, you might see a marginal increase in the prices of the new projects that would be launched. So the buyers need to keep these this point in mind. Now, what happens to the under construction project where the developer has an option of either, you know, of foregoing input tax credit and charging lesser GST vis-a-vis avail input tax credit? Now, if we go back to the basic premise on which the government abolished input tax credit was that most of the developers, or rather I would say few of the developers, were not passing on this benefit to the buyers. And that was the reason, logic behind bringing down the GST rate and completely removing this IT, input tax credit. So this kind of, you know, creates a kind of confusion in the minds of buyers as well. So in my opinion, from the buyer's point of view, now they'll have an option of either wait till 1st of April and kind of, you know, take into mind that any new purchase that would, they will be doing, it would have a risk of a slightly increased price, but a lower GST. Or they, you know,
right,
they go with the projects which are kind of, you know, they're charging higher GST, but the prices would be slightly low. So in a net effect, the impact for a buyer would be, you know, nullified. Now, if I have to talk from a developer point of view, I think definitely availing input tax credit would protect their margin slightly. But in my opinion, a more balanced approach would have been a reduction in the GST rate of cement and paints, which are, you know, at 28%. And, you know, continue with 5% and 1% GST and no input tax credit would have been a more win-win situation for all the stakeholders.
All right, Prashant.
How I would summarize.
Fair point there, Prashant. Thanks a lot for that. Just for the record, GST on paints has been reduced from 28% to 18%. Cement is what remains. Thanks a lot, all of you all, for joining in with this discussion. But meanwhile, before we wrap up on this show, we jump across to another story that has been developing.